is that we are so very busy, we have no time for the Lord. And this is the opportunity that the church given to us in order that we can avail ourselves in refocusing ourselves on Jesus. Yes, it is our Philippine practice to have Misa di Gallio. Remember, the Pope celebrated Simbang Gabi in relation to the Misa di Gallio. That the church appreciate our practice of Simbang Gabi or Misa di Gallio. I will not use anymore Simbang Gabi because Archbishop really invites us priests to celebrate Misa di Gallio, not Simbang Gabi. Specify that this is our practice. We are refocusing ourselves on Jesus, who is the light of the world. Every day we pray, Father, please help me to pray. I have this experience of darkness today. We cannot have this if we don't want to refocus ourselves on Jesus, who is the light of the world. Light. Known in their practice of Digan as Sol Invictus, now referring to Jesus, who is the Sol Invictus, the sun that never sets. It is very clear, brothers and sisters, that in our good news today, it talks about the theme of life. Kahaya. Jesus declared himself as the greater light, greater than John the Baptist. Indeed, Jesus is the greatest light. When Jesus did a positive comment on John the Baptist, that he is the burning lamp, the light that shines before him, Jesus underlines, and he underlines this, that the greatest tribute that we can give to Jesus, who is the light of the world, is not to brighten our houses and streets with electrical lights, with different forms of lantern, with different colors. It is not that. Because if we celebrate Christmas just like that only, we remain in the pagan practice of celebrating like a festival of life. Remember, we move on already. That is why the greatest tribute that we can give, declaring Jesus as the light of the world, is to make ourselves the children of light. The light of Jesus, who is the light of the world, the true Sol Invictus. That's the point, brothers and sisters. That is why John chapter 8, verse 12, he says that he is the light, and he will come to share the light of those who will accept him and those who will believe in him. He is the light. The Gospel of John, chapter 8, verse 12, and sharing his light to those who will welcome him and those who will believe in him. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 14. That is why celebrating Christmas is an invitation for us to become the children of light. And I'm so thankful that the tabernacle is represented with the sun. before that, at least there is one celebration that will focus on Jesus, the birth of Jesus in 1 year, the Christmas celebration. I remind you, brothers and sisters, we have this 9-day Misa in that year. Misa in that year. And brothers and sisters, this is not just to offer sacrifice in waking up early and offering the sacrifice to Jesus. Yes, it is that reason. But I remind you, brothers and sisters, we have this Mass early as it should be. That is that, that is 3 o'clock, and now we have this 4:30. This is an opportunity that is given to those farmers and those who will wake up early to go to work, to have the opportunity to attend the Mass, the Masses. This is the practice that we give to those who will be waking up early to have Mass. What for? It is an opportunity to focus themselves on Jesus, who is the source of everything that we need every day of our lives. Sacrifice, picking up early, and also we can be available to say and to have the Mass to receive Jesus. That is our practice as we prepare for the coming of Christ. Let me recall and told you, it is the festival of life, then baptized by the Christian in the annual traditional commemoration of the birth of Jesus, the light of the world. We are invited to become the children of light. First, we need